So one simple way to make your second brain more powerful is by connecting your thoughts and your ideas together. Ideas are not meant to be in isolation. They become refined and they become stronger when they are connected together. It reminds me of the redwood forest, the sequoia trees. They grow up to 300 feet. They're the tallest trees in the world. And yet, their root system is only 8 to 10 feet deep. Why? How can they grow? It's because of the connections. Their root system is actually connected to trees around them and their root systems, and then those are connected to trees around them. And it's all interconnected, and that's what helps them grow to 300 feet. Our ideas are the same. They become stronger, they're able to grow when they are connected. So in this video, I want to talk about the three ways to find connections between your ideas and your second brain. I will say that all of these methods, all these ways here can be done in any digital app. It doesn't matter. But the one that I'll be showing to you today is gonna be craft. Number one is first thoughts. So as you come across and capture an idea or a thought, your brain is already doing what it's designed to do. It's making connections. What you're capturing immediately reminds you of something. Like you have an idea or you come across an article and it reminds you of something else. Maybe it's a story. Maybe it's another article. And maybe you've already captured that in your second brain. What you want to do is actually in the moment link that to the thing that you're thinking of. So you can do that by searching for it. Okay. And you may think, I'll remember that as you're writing down your thought or idea. You won't. What you want to do is link as you think. Okay. So as you think about it, go ahead and link it. Search for it. See if it's there. If not, then just write it down as another thought that you had as you were capturing this thought or idea. Now, one thing that I love about craft is the ability to link not just to other documents or pages or notes, but you can link to blocks within those documents. So if you have something specific that you want to link to or that you're thinking about, you can actually link it to that thing, which makes it great for discoverability. So when you're going back through the note, you can actually see the exact content that you linked it to, the exact sentence or quote that you were thinking of as it relates to this, the idea or the thought that you captured. You want to be able to know why you linked that note, right? And so the more specific that you can get with the linking, the more easier it is to understand why you linked that other thought or the idea. Number two is ask questions. We want to create habits of asking ourselves questions whenever we jot down our ideas. Why questions? Because questions actually help trigger our brains to make connections. It makes it easy. You'll just answer the questions that you're asking yourself to help you make the connections. So some of the questions that I'll ask myself is, what does this idea remind me of? Or where have I seen this before? Or what project am I working on that this may benefit from? Or maybe what comes before or after this thought or idea that I have? If you already have questions that you ask yourself when you are documenting and capturing ideas, let me know. I'd love to hear those in the comments below. And also you can create a template, you know, that already has questions built in. With any, a new idea template or something like that. So when you click that template, it already has those built in. You don't have to ask and think about what were the questions again. It's just right there and you can just answer the questions and then link to the other documents. By the way, if you're finding value in this video, please let me know by hitting that like button. Number three is search for keywords. This is one of my favorite things to do. So when I jot down an idea or a thought or I save an article, I usually have an idea of what the topics or topic that it's covering. And so I'll go ahead and search for that keyword in my second brain to see if anything else comes up. Because what happens is I usually will find a note that I've jotted down that I forgot that I wrote down. And so I'm able to catch those things that I wouldn't have caught with the first thoughts method or asking questions. Now, I will use also the AI and craft to actually help me generate keywords. So I'll ask it to generate keywords and it'll spit out a list for me. And then I can actually search those keywords for anything else that I may have that's related and connected to the thought that I'm capturing. If you enjoyed this video and you'd like more content just like this, consider subscribing. Thanks so much for watching.